State?
We're prepared to make a factual finding.
Okay.
Your Honor, if this case charging the defendant Nicholas Jacob Cruz with 17 counts of first-degree murder and 17 counts of attempted first-degree murder went to trial, the state would be able to prove beyond an exclusion of every reasonable doubt that the defendant committed each and every one of the counts in the indictment, to wit, 17 counts of first-degree murder and 17 counts of attempted first-degree murder. Some of the evidence that would prove that the defendant is guilty of each and every one of the counts in the indictment, but not exclusive, are school surveillance videos, other surveillance videos, witness testimony, witness identifications, DNA, and the defendant's statements, all of which would be incriminating to the defendant. This is just some of the competent evidence that the state would introduce at trial. The whole of that evidence would establish the following facts, Your Honor. On Wednesday, February the 14th, 2018, the defendant, Nicholas Jacob Cruz, contacted Uber and had a driver drive him to Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School, located 5901 Pine Island Road in Broward County, Florida. The defendant had with him a rifle bag which contained his Smith & Wesson M&P 15 caliber 5.56 rifle, which is an AR-15 type rifle. He had a backpack that contained a tactical vest that had pockets for firearm magazines. The defendant brought with him to Marjory Stoneman Douglas 11 firearm magazines. He directed the driver of Uber to drop him off at Pine Island Road in front of the pedestrian gate located on the northeast side of Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School. The defendant walked through the pedestrian gate and made his way to the 1200 building. The defendant, Nicholas Cruz, had previously attended Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School. He approached the 1200 building, which is located on the northeast corner of the campus. It is the only three-story building on the campus of Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School. He entered the east doors of the 1200 building. The 1200 building has 10 classrooms on each floor, 6 classrooms on the north, on the south, and 4 classrooms on the north. That's on each floor of the 34 building, on the three-story building. Upon entering the east doors of the 1200 building, Nicholas Cruz turned right and walked into the east stairwell of the 1200 building. He then proceeded to take out his rifle from the rifle bag and loaded it with one of the magazines. As the defendant was loading the magazine into his rifle, a student walked into the east stairwell, and the defendant said to him, "You better get out of here. Something bad is about to happen." The defendant then entered the hallway at approximately 2:21:33, and he fired his rifle at 4 students who were in the hallway. 3 of the students were in front of classroom 1215 on the south side of the hallway. Gina Montalto was sitting outside the classroom of 1215 working on her computer. Martin Duque Anguiano and Lou Coyer were standing next to her, knocking on the classroom door to gain entrance. Ashley Baez was further west walking down the hallway towards the west doors. The defendant fired his rifle at Gina Montalto, Martin Duque Anguiano, and Lou Coyer. They were all shot. Ashley Baez was shot in the leg, but she managed to run to a classroom 1210 across the hall. Ashley Baez survived her wounds. The defendant then turned and fired into the classroom window door of classroom 1216 on the north side of the hallway. He then knelt down in the hallway, took off his backpack, pulled out his tactical vest, put the vest on, loaded another magazine, and he crossed the hallway to the south side of the hallway once again to classroom 1215 and 1214, which are both adjoining classrooms. He again fired into Gina Montalto, Martin Duque Anguiano, and Lou Coyer. Gina Montalto, 14 years old, who was sitting in the hallway in front of classroom 1215, was shot 4 times and died of her wounds. Martin Duque Anguiano, 14 years old, was shot 8 times, and he died of his wounds. Luke Coyer, 15 years old, was shot twice, and he died of his wounds. The defendant then began firing through the glass window again into 1214. Then he went across the hall, placed another firearm magazine in his rifle, returned to 1214, and fired once again into classroom 1214. 6 of the students in classroom 1214 were shot. Helena Ramsay, 17 years old, was shot 4 times, and she died of her wounds. Nicholas Dworet, 17 years old, was shot 3 times, and Nicholas died of his wounds. Isabel Checker, Danielle Menescule, Samantha Grady, Samantha Fuentes were wounded, but they survived their wounds. The defendant then walked east in the hallway and once again fired through the classroom window door of classroom 1216. He shot 8 students in classroom 1216. Alex Schachter, 14 years old, was shot twice, and he died of his wounds. Alaina Petty, 14 years old, was shot 4 times, and she died of her wounds. Alyssa Alhadeff was shot 8 times, and she died of her wounds. William Olson, Justin Colton, Genesis Valentin, Alexander Dworet, and Keshava Magapuriam were wounded, but they survived their wounds. The defendant went back across again to 1214, and he fired into 1214 once again. He was, as he was doing that, Coach Christopher Hixon opened the west doors of the first floor hallway and ran in to see what was happening. The defendant fired his rifle at Christopher Hixon, hitting him twice. Christopher Hixon, wounded, crawled across the hallway and hid in one of the alcoves on the north side of the hallway. The defendant then walked up to classroom 1213 on the north side of the first floor hallway and fired through the glass door in the glass in the classroom door. Carmen Schentrup, 16 years old, was shot 3 times, and she died of her wounds. Madeline Wilford was shot multiple times, but she survived. Samantha Mayer was shot multiple times. She survived. And Benjamin Wickander was shot multiple times, but he survived. The defendant then continued west down the first floor hallway, and as he passed Christopher Hixon, who was hiding in the alcove, he fired once again into Christopher Hixon. Coach Hixon was shot 3 times, and he died of his wounds. The defendant then entered the west stairwell, and as he entered the west stairwell, there is a door to the west stairwell. And coming in through the door on the west stairwell, which was Coach Aaron Feis. As Coach Aaron Feis opened the door, the defendant fired twice into Coach Feis, who fell by the west stairwell door. Coach Feis died of his wounds. The defendant then went up the west stairwell and entered the second floor hallway. As he went down the hallway, he fired into classroom 1231, which was empty, which was on the north side of the hallway. He then crossed the hallway and fired to classroom 1234. It's on the south side of the hallway. That classroom was also empty. He then walked up to the east stairwell, and he walked up the stairs. Due to the percussion from the defendant firing his rifle, the dust from the ceiling tiles caused the fire alarm system to sense smoke, causing the fire alarm to sound. Because the fire alarm was sounding, the students and the teachers were evacuating their classrooms due to the fire alarm sounding. The defendant, upon reaching the third floor, as he exited the stairwell, he fired into Scott Beigel, who was a classroom teacher in 1256. Scott Beigel was shot 4 times, and Scott Beigel died of his wounds. The defendant then fired at another teacher, Stacy LaPelle, who was out in the hallway with Scott Beigel. She was wounded, but she survived her wounds. She was a classroom teacher in classroom 1255. As the students and teachers were running back to their classrooms, the defendant placed another magazine into his rifle and proceeded to fire. He shot Meadow Pollack, who was hiding in an alcove of classroom 1249, along with Cara Loughran, as they hid in that alcove. The defendant then shot down the hall Anthony Borges multiple times. Anthony Borges survived his wounds. Marion Kabachenko was shot, but he survived his wounds. Kyle Lehman was shot, and he survived his wound. The defendant continued to fire as he moved down the hallway, shooting Meadow Pollack, Cara Loughran, Joaquin Oliver Padoy, Peter Wang, and Jaime Guttenberg. The defendant continued further west in the hallway, and as he approached Meadow Pollack and Cara Loughran, who were still in the hallway, lying on the floor in the alcove of 1249, fired into them once again. Meadow Pollack, 18 years old, was shot 6 times, and she died of her wounds. Cara Loughran, 14 years old, was shot 3 times and died of her wounds. The defendant then approached the alcove of the men's bathroom on the north side of the hall. Lying wounded on the floor in front of the men's bathroom door was Joaquin Oliver Padoy. The defendant once again fired into Joaquin Oliver Padoy. Joaquin Oliver Padoy was 17 years old. He was shot 4 times and he died of his wounds. The defendant then approached Peter Wang, who was wounded and laying just outside the hallway of the west stairwell. Peter Wang was 14 years old. He was shot 12 times and he died of his wounds. Jaime Guttenberg, 14 years old, as she was running down the hall, she was able to reach the door on the west side of the hallway. She was shot and she died of her wounds. The defendant then entered the teacher's lounge, which is on 1240. It was on the north side of the hallway. And he fired 5 rounds outside the west window. The window overlooks a courtyard and the parking lot. He then turned and fired out of a south window that looks over a courtyard. He fired 10 shots in total. He then ran out of 1240 and went into the west stairwell, took off his vest that still contained 5 firearm magazines. He laid his gun down, and he ran out of down the stairs and out of the 1200 building on the west side, and he left the 1200 building at 2:27:55 p.m. He then ran and blended in with students who were evacuating the campus due to the fire alarm. As he walked away into a residential neighborhood, he was arrested at 3:49 p.m., approximately 3 miles away from Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School. They're the facts, Your Honor, that we would like on the record as a factual basis for the plea.
Okay. Based upon the stipulation as well as the factual basis presented by the state, I do find there's a factual basis for the plea. And based upon the defendant's guilty plea, I am going to adjudicate him guilty of counts 1 through 34 of the indictment. Also, a matter that was not was placed on the record but not in the defendant's presence is that I did adjudicate the defendant guilty of all 4 counts of the information in case. This was done on Friday. In case number 1814129, I did on Friday, which was the October 15th, I adjudicated defendant guilty of count 1, attempted aggravated battery on a law enforcement officer, count 2, battery on a law enforcement officer, count 3, depriving an officer means of protection, and count 4, of the information. The defendant was adjudicated guilty. Now that he has been adjudicated guilty, I intend to set the homicide case for trial on the sentencing phase 2 trial.